Hello, this is Joey. Welcome to day two of Vlogtober. I wanted to talk today about running. This is an activity that I participate in from time to time, not as often as I would like. I kind of go through spurts, but it's a fun activity and something I really enjoy. I wanted to talk about it a little bit. I'm actually making this video. I'm waiting. Got a delay in my schedule. I was gonna go out and run a little bit earlier, but I discovered that they're actually running a half marathon on the part of the course that I was going to run on. So I decided that I would wait until that's mostly over, and then I would go out and run. Anyway, so I started running in January of 2010, which was about a year and a half ago, or over a year and a half ago from the making of this video. Started out because I had gotten into a challenge at work with some people. We were gonna, first thing we were gonna do is not drink any soda and for 4 months. And during that 4 months, we were gonna train and run the country music half marathon. So I signed up for it on January 1st and stopped drinking sodas and started my training at the end of January. So we were actually gonna walk the half marathon. I was the only one that followed through with it, by the way, but I did follow through with it. So there's that. So started out walking. Then I started adding short run intervals in as I got more and more. I started out running walking short distances, a mile, and then like 2 miles, and then worked my way up to about 3 miles. And I was running walking 3 to 4 miles, 4 to 5 times a week, and then or 3 times a week, and then on the weekend I would run or walk a longer distance. So I think my first week I started out at 5 miles for the weekend walk. So I did that. And then I started running short intervals. I would walk 5 minutes, run for 30 seconds, walk 5 minutes, run for 30 seconds. And gradually over time I increased the running intervals and shortened the walk intervals. And then I went to straight running. And I did that by walking or running only at a pace that was as fast as my walking pace. So me running, I was running so slow that my fastest walking pace, I probably could have almost kept up with myself. But it did help me to start running, because running is a different motion, so you kind of have to train your body to do that, whatever. So it worked out really well the way I did it. So if you're kind of fat and out of shape like I was, then that's kind of a good way to go about it. And also at around that time I bought a really nice pair of running shoes. Dropped about $100 on it, but it's a good idea. If you're gonna start running or if you're gonna start running walking, to go out and get a good pair of shoes. Do what you have to do to get the shoes. If you don't have any money and you got to sell something, whatever you got to do, get it, because it really does help. So my first race was a 5K, and I did that in about 36 minutes. I don't remember my exact time, but I did run the whole distance. So I was really proud of myself for that. And I actually met some people at the race, and that I've been briefly talking to, that also run here in the Nashville area. And so I've been kind of making a few running buddies, is what I call them, because we mainly just talk about running and things like that. So after that I ran the country music half marathon, and I did a pretty good job of that. I can't remember, I was running some kind of interval, 2 minutes run, 1 minute walk, or something like that. And I did pretty well until mile 9, and then I kind of got tired and wore out, and ended up finishing. I think my goal time was 2 hours and 45 minutes, and I ended up with a 2 hour, 45 minutes, and 54 seconds. So I was only 54 seconds away from my goal time, but it was kind of a disappointment, but I was so glad to get that accomplishment under my belt. So I was really happy about that. Then over the summer, I didn't really do any races. I did one race, the Firecracker 5K, which I got a big PR in because I was taking these. I took this running class. It's called Summer Speed Sessions, and basically, they just work on your technique for running faster in shorter races, like a 5K, which is about 3 miles, pretty short. And so I did. I got a lot faster. I think my time was 28 minutes something. So I knocked about 6, 7, 8 minutes off my time in the 5K. So that's pretty good. Then I ran another half marathon in Chicago and knocked 27 minutes off my half marathon time. So that was a good deal. And I run another one in October of that year. Knocked 2 minutes off my time, but I had not trained for like 2 months before that, so that was quite a feat to actually do that. And I took a bathroom break in the middle of that one. Then I run a relay race from Chattanooga to Nashville. That was fun. That was a group activity. Came in dead last, but it was really fun. I really enjoyed myself. Met a lot of great people. Hung out with a lot of great people. So that was super fun. I did another half marathon in December, the St. Jude half marathon, and that's actually the first half marathon I run the entire distance. So I was proud of myself for that. I didn't knock any. I actually had a little bit slower time than some of my previous half marathons, but it was a good deal to run the whole thing. So that was fun. And then I did some pretty intense training, and then at the end of February, or at the beginning of February of this year, for whatever reason, I stopped training. And I've had a really hard time this year training. I just can't get into it. And more on that later. I'll probably talk about that tomorrow. I did run the Tom King 5K, which was the first 5K I run last year. I run that in March, and a half marathon on the same day. So that's about 16 miles total. I got a PR, a personal record, in the 5K with very little training. I hadn't trained in a month and a half, but the half marathon really broke me down, and I couldn't walk for about a week after that. I was so stiff and bound up. Then I took another break from training, and I think in June I started running again. Run some in June and in July, and I run a 5K, the Firecracker 5K. I run that one again this year. Did okay on that one. Let my training slack off again, and now it's October, and I'm gonna run a half marathon, the Murfreesboro half marathon, which I ran last year. Did really well in. I've got 2 weeks to train for that, so I don't expect to do well. I think my goal time is going to be about 2 hours and 37 minutes, which would be a 12 minutes per mile. But I don't want to end up like I did after Tom King, which was this year, which was unable to walk for a week. I just can't do that. So I guess I could, but I'm going to work on, you know, training a little bit up for the next 2 weeks, but I'm not going to try to overexert myself because I'm just don't want to go through that pain. So I do plan to do some more running. Checking the time now, so sorry about that. About 10 minutes in, so I'm doing pretty good. I'm going to plan doing some more running this year. I want to try to run another half marathon or some kind of race in November. I'd love to do a half marathon, but it's going to be about the cost of it. I don't make a lot of money, so gotta do that. And I'm saving up for a trip. I want to do the Las Vegas half marathon in December 4th. I want to do that one. but I don't know that I'll be able to do that. It's really expensive, and I've got to plan the trip. I've been saving money up for it, but I'm still kind of undecided on it. I need to make that decision in the next like week or two. So I'll probably talk a little bit more about running throughout October as I do daily vlogs. So I'll give you an update on that when I actually sign up for it. So I'm 99% sure I'm going to sign up for it. I just got to get all my ducks in a row, figure out how much money I've got, and then we'll see what's going on with that. But next year, I'm hoping to run a half marathon every month. So the reason I want to do that is because one of my big problems, and I'll talk about that tomorrow, is maintaining my training for more than a few months at a time. So I'm thinking that if I give myself that goal of running once a month, running a half marathon every month, then I should have a easier time maintaining my training. Even if I kind of fall off of my training, I'll still be running at least once a month, and having to keep myself kind of in shape for that. So I'm hoping that will help me out. And I'm picking the half marathon distance because the shorter races are, they're not like a true indication of your fitness. Like, just about anybody can go out and run a 5K. Not anybody, but if you're in any kind of shape, you can go out and run a 5K. It's only 3 miles, so you know, you'll be really tired at the end, and but you can go out and do it. But the half marathon is 13 miles, so that's a little bit more challenging for an average person, especially if they're not very active. So that distance would require me to stay in better shape. So that's my plan for next year. Anyway, that's my talk about running. I'll probably run and talk a little bit more about specific topics later in the month. But for right now, just giving you a general review of how I started running and what my plans are for the future. Anyway, peace out, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.